Hey you, yes you, the one looking for a quick and easy way to create those sleek, retro-futuristic 3D wireframes in After Effects. Well, you're in luck. Today, I'm going to show you a fast, simple method that doesn't require any paid plugins, complex setups, or selling your soul to the 3D gods. Now, I personally love this clean, minimal wireframe look. It just screams cool, like something straight out of Tron. Minus, of course, the risk of getting sucked into a video game. Usually, making wireframes can be a bit of a pain, but I've got a method that's fast, renders like a dream, and wait for it, it's completely free. And who doesn't love free stuff? Now, if you're a kind of a person who skips to the end of the book, shame on you, there's a direct download link in the description. Just slap this preset onto any solid and reference a 3D model or 3D text in your composition, and voila, instant wireframe magic. But if you actually want to know what's going on, stick around and I'll show you how to get the best results, what are the limitations, and how this method stack up against Cinema 4D and Element 3D. Before I unveil my secret sauce, let's talk about the existing methods and why they might not be ideal. We'll start with the Cinema effect, basically a Cinema 4D file inside After Effects. So if you have one of these, you can drag it, and this is going to apply the Cinema effect. I already have it over here. And then you can set the display to wireframe and adjust the renderer to fit. If you want colors, you can add the levels effect and crush the black and the white, and then add a fill effect to colorize. And this works, but it's a bit messy. You have limited control over the wireframe thickness. Actually, you don't have any controls. And there are no way to hide the backlines. All right, let's try something else. Let's go with Element 3D, which is, of course, a paid plugin, one of my favorite ones. And this one has a built-in wireframe material with more control. So you can change the thickness of the lines, for example. Now, again, this will create a see-through situation, which is not ideal for some cases. And of course, this is not free. You need to pay for the plugin. Now, if you are a 3D person, you can, of course, use Cinema 4D, Blender, or other 3D packages. And this will allow you to be ultra specific and get really fine with the look that you're after. But of course, it requires an actual 3D knowledge. And if this is your thing, you can check out my buddy Aaron Rabinowitz's tutorial. The link is down below, which is going to show you how to set it up in Cinema 4D and Redshift. Great technique. But enough complaining. Let's talk about some fun way to create it using After Effects native effects. So to save time, I already set up a simple composition with an extruded text that says The Wire. An amazing show, by the way. Watch it. Now, here's how to create a wireframe look. First, you need to make sure that you are using the advanced 3D renderer. Next, override the front and side colors, and you can do it using a text animator. So pick contrasting colors. In this case, I'm using pink and yellow, but you can go wild with this. Then I've added a camera and a null object that controls the camera and spin it around for a sleek loop. And now comes the magic sauce. So let's build the wireframe preset together, or at least I'll do it and you will watch. I'll start by adding a solid layer. It needs to be in the comp size, but the color doesn't matter because we're going to replace it really soon. Actually now, by applying the CC composite effect. This one needs to reference the 3D objects. In this case, I'll reference it with the text that I have here and set the transfer mode to copy, making sure not to tick the RGB only checkbox. Then I'll turn off the visibility of the text layer in the timeline. We are just using it as a reference. Then I'll apply the Find Edges effect and check the Invert checkbox. Next, I'll apply Posterize, which will reduce the shading, so you'll need to adjust it as needed. I'll leave it in its default settings for now. And in order to make it transparent, I'm going to use the unmult preset, which is going to take the alpha from the lightness using the shift channel effect and clean it up with the remove color matting. I'm also going to apply the transform effect, which is necessary if you want to move, scale, or rotate the object after the fact, and I'll show you how to use it in a moment. Now, I can refine the lines using the minimax effect, which will help us to thicken the lines by setting it to maximum and making sure to apply it to the alpha and color. And then for final touches, I'll add the fill effect. And in this case, I'll choose a bright neon color. Let's go with a bright cyan. And then I'll top it off with the glow effect. In this case, I'll set the threshold and the radius both to 20 for this gorgeous fluorescent shine. And that's it. Crisp, clean, and retro futuristic. No weird back transparency issues, just a sleek wireframe that works. Now you can save all of these settings as an animation preset, and if you're unsure how to do it, check the card above, or of course you can download my free preset. And now that we have this working, let's use it with some actual 3D models. So in the project panel, I have a folder with a few 3D models, and I'll start with this adorable robot from sketchfab.com. Links to everything I'm using down below. I'm going to create a comp out of it, and then in the timeline, I'll make sure to enable animation for this model. It has a built-in or embedded animation. And now I can trim the comp because we love to be efficient, don't we? Next, I'm going to add a new solid and apply the wireframe preset. In this case, I'll select the model from the drop-down menu. And right after, I can turn off its visibility in the timeline and then use the transform effect in the preset to change the position, scale, rotation of the model in the composition view. The next thing is to tweak the colors and other settings, so make it your own. Just play with it and enjoy. And if I'll press spacebar, you can see how this works. Beautiful. Now, if you like, you can drag more stuff. So let's drag another 3D model, in this case, this spaceship. And in this case, I'm going to select the model, then hold down Command Control on the Windows side and double click on the Pan Behind tool, which is going to center the anchor point in the middle of this object, which is going to help me to rotate it. So I'm going to expose the rotation properties in the timeline or use the properties panel, whatever you fancy. And then I'll option click on the Y rotation to enable an expression and type in time times negative 50 for an endless spinning. Then I'll duplicate the solid layer and I'll swap the model reference with this one. And of course, switch off the visibility of the original 3D object. And then I can reposition it, scale it, and move it on screen until I'm happy. Of course, you can also select different colors and just have fun with it. And if you want to rinse and repeat, you can do it to as many models as you like. Just for the fun of it, let's add another one. This time, a floating astronaut. So again, make sure you can see the entire model in the frame. You may need to scale it depending on the size of the model that you are bringing. But I think that this one also has an animation track, so I'll enable it. And then I'll stretch its speed to fit the comp duration by holding down Option and dragging the end of the clip. Wow, a good tip that I've already discussed before. Anyhow, now I can play with the orientation using the 3D gizmo. And once I'm happy, I'll switch off the layer and repeat the same process by duplicating the solid with the preset and replacing the source layer and modify the other settings until he will be where I want him to be. Now in this case, for some reason, I can't see the model. And if this happens to you, just click reset in the transform effect because we're actually duplicating the previous one and this one had different settings. So I can now start again until he's where he needs to be. Now, if you want to change the 3D settings, just return to the original 3D models and then play with the various options from there. This is also true if you want to animate them, as I showed you. But there you have it, a super sleek 3D wireframe animation inside After Effects without any plugins, no headaches, and buttery smooth performance. Now check out this alternative version with more models and a different title. Doesn't it feel like we just stepped into an 80s sci-fi dream? Just don't unplug the power cord unless you want to deal with Optimus Prime. Wait, wrong franchise. Who cares? Anyhow, now it's your turn to shine. I hope this tutorial helped you. And if you feel that you have the power of neon wireframe coursing through your veins, let me know in the comments below. And also share your creation with me. Tag me at SternFX so I can bask in your awesomeness. And of course, hit that like and subscribe because my After Effects oven is still baking some hot new tutorials that you don't want to miss. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.